Get ready to match the stars, Don Galloway, Rick Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from Barnaby Jones, Lee Merriweather, Bill Daly, and Patty Doyle, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Not even a new kid on the block.
I've aroused your libido.
Can we say that on the air? I guess we can.
Yeah, you can say libido. Libido. Say libido.
No, I can't say libido.
Oh, you can't say that. Uh-huh. Knitted it yourself, eh?
Yeah, it's got... You want to see the hole in it?
Yeah, there it is.
Jaws goes too short.
I don't know what belongs... I think it's one of my daughters. I must have picked
it
up.
Oh, really?
I don't know where it came from.
It's beautiful.
How's the back?
It's handed. You can tell it's hand done.
It
it's very, very attractive. Okay, here's old Jay Brooks, the current champ here.
Yeah.
Come on down here, Jay. A little grapefruit juice. Like some?
May I?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah. You get dehydrated here under the hot lights there. Mm. Mm. It is grapefruit juice, right?
I can attest to that. I don't know what else.
No, that's it. Okay, I'll put this right here. Now, when we were together last time, he played the first part of the audience match, won the $500, and that means the least he'll play for is $5,000. However, he's going to spin the wheel, and if he gets a lucky spin of the wheel, he'll double his money and play for $10,000. Good luck to you. We'll all root for a double. Here we go. A double. Here's the gold star area. You're going to play with Don Galloway. You ready, Don?
Oh.
I
thought there was another Don here.
No, okay, you're the only Don on the show. Lee, Bill, Patty, Charles, Brett.
That's not me.
No. It's got to be you, Don. You're the only one.
Okay.
Now, you're going to write your answer, and he'll give us a verbal response. Okay, good luck to you. Here it is. This is what it says. No help from the audience, please. Blank candle. C-A-N-D-L-E. Blank candle. Okay, now, Don has written his answer, put it in a slot. If you give us the answer that he has on the card, we give you $10,000.
Oh, God, that'd be nice.
Yes, it would be.
Yes.
You give it to me? I thought it'd be nice, too.
I'm going to go with Christmas candle.
Christmas candle. A smattering of applause indicates that it's not the niftiest answer in the world. But we'll find out. Don, he said Christmas candle will match you. What do you say to that?
I'm sorry, I'm still back to Julius Caesar, I guess. I said Roman candle.
Roman candle, yeah. What do they say? Birthday candle. Oh, that's not bad, audience.
No,
very good one.
Praises. Birthday candle. It's not a phrase, and neither is a Christmas candle.
All right. Whatever you say.
Tree is.
Whatever you say. Now, Jay, you will meet another player in a little bit, but right now we're going to do a little business with America, okay?
Great. All right.
Listen, no, that was a very good answer. Yes. Very good. Now, let's all welcome our new player here, Gail Gardner. Applause, applause. Hey, Gail. Got to get acquainted with you first before we start. What do you want to say about yourself?
I'm a student of psychology, and I'm the sixth of a Brady Bunch, and I'm doing field work in psychology right now. I'm a bartender.
Uh-huh. What's going on in my mind right now?
I don't know.
Okay.
I do.
Nobody asked you.
I know.
Well, what about it, Bill? No. Gail, we wish you the very best of luck. We'll start now by asking you to choose A or B.
Bobby's going to kill me, but I'm going to say A.
Bob's going to kill you?
A. Yeah, my little brother Bobby, he wants me to pick B, but I'm going to pick A.
Oh. Is he here, your little brother Bobby?
No, he's not here.
No, who's here?
Nobody's here right now.
Oh, you didn't bring any friends?
I wouldn't.
No relatives?
Mm-mm.
Okay, have you met Jay Brooks?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Ralph said, when I was born, my parents left me in a kitchen drawer. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Ready, done.
Yeah.
Put it in the slot there. See, when you put it in the slot there, your light turns on there, and I know you're finished.
Okay, Gail, where's the question?
Honey, here's
the answer. There. Yeah. Here's the answer.
Premature senility setting.
Okay, what does it say? Oh, it said, Ralph said, when I was born, my parents left me in a kitchen drawer. For years, I thought I was a blank.
A steak knife.
A steak knife. Your brother Bob is applauding. Okay, Don.
I got a little carried away making a market list here, but this may be a match. I had a knife, a fork, or a spoon. Is that...
Knife, fork,
a spoon.
I mean,
that's those three things that go by your plate. Yeah. Thing. It's not a match.
Would you like to explain that just for our benefit? You got three answers. Okay. And she specifically said steak knife. All right.
Well, I thought of things like tea cozy, but I realize that nobody has things like that.
I have a tea cozy.
I do, too.
A downfill tea cozy.
I do, too.
Why, you little Nancy.
Downfill tea cozies keep your tea hot for hours. They're wonderful.
I know, they do. It's a true thing. He looks like a basketball something, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's a big basketball jock.
Yeah, he sure is. I said egg beater.
Egg beater. Left me a kitchen drawer for years. I thought it was an egg beater. No, she...
Right, Jack?
She said steak knife. What do you say?
Well, I use this for everything. Bread knife.
A bread knife.
Barbara Streisand uses a grapefruit knife for everything. She changes the tire in her car with it. Everything.
Yeah.
Name dropper.
Okay. Gail Gardner said a steak knife specifically, and that's what we have for her to score.
Well, then I'm sorry, Gail. I said a spatula.
A spatula. Now, if someone says just knife, K-N-I-F-E, without specifying bread knife or anything like that, that would match
spoon.
Steak knife. Uh-huh. What do you got?
I've got steak fork.
Steak fork. Yeah. Listen, you know, you're funnier with a beard.
Not for long.
Okay.
This may be a match.
This may be a match. All right, listen carefully now. Watch carefully. Here we go.
A baggie.
A baggie. Close. Yeah, that was as close as we got there. Okay, Jay Brooks, first round question for you. Reads, Fido the dog said.
Yeah.
The dog is speaking.
Uh-huh.
Oh! He says, it's tough having a practical joker for a master. For my birthday, he got me a blanking fire plug. It's tough having a practical joker for a master. For my birthday, he got me a blanking fire plug. Now, you can change your mind if you want to.
Can I change my mind? Okay, I'll change
my
mind.
All right, anything you say.
Okay, I changed my mind. I put it back in again. I just want to be able to change my mind.
Okay. All right, Jay. Fido the dog said, it's tough having a practical joker for a master. For my birthday... He got me a blanking fire plug.
I'll have to say a walking fire plug.
A walking fire plug.
Moves
around. Moves around.
Can't stay in station. It's not stationary.
And what would be the practical joke aspect of that?
Well, every time, no.
Well, think about it for
a
minute.
Give it a minute. My goodness gracious, do you want me to demonstrate? We'll be the fire plug.
It's your turn to be the fire plug. Okay, Galloway.
I was thinking more about gay festival times and how you light things up, and I said a flashing fire plug.
A flashing fire plug.
Thank you. God bless
you. That would be it.
That was your mother.
His mother is flashing?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I don't want an argument. I've been cranky this week. You don't want me to get started on the property taxes again.
No, we don't.
Okay. Now, rolling or moving?
Well, that's it. Not walking, huh? Rolling or moving is not walking.
Well, I said moving.
Moving.
And
no.
Oh.
Oh, hard-hearted Hannah for the judge this week, boy. I tell you, Lee.
He's a tough man.
Tough having a practical joker for a master. For my birthday, got me a blanking fire plug, and Jay said walking.
Well, the worst practical joker that ever did something to me was the little flower, you know.
The squirting.
And I figured, you know, it's...
Fire plugs have water.
Yes, so squirting.
Hey, squirting. Yeah, I think that would be the definitive answer. That's what the joke, you know, you go up, the guy's got a boutonniere there, and he says, oh, smell your flower, and he squeezes a little rubber thing in his pocket, and there's
and
a tube,
high time that
and the water
interesting
squirts.
If
the fire
it's
hydrants
moving.
Got back at the dog.
That's right. It's about time. Okay, bearded sage man.
It really throws me when they boo me, and I give my answer, so could you boo me now? Oh!
Terrible. Okay.
Mine was a burning fire plug because
wait a minute, you already did it.
Now, come on,
this is not a two-boo joke. This is a
right,
one-boo.
Right.
No boo-boos.
Yeah.
Who's that?
One boo per answer is all we allow.
One fatty.
Yeah.
Two-boo?
Yeah, that's right.
Two-boo or not two-boo? That was the answer. Where is it? Give me that answer back again.
Well, it didn't match anyway. Walking is what we need here.
Walking, oh.
He's gotten so surly since he grew that thing.
Yeah, I think it makes him feel powerful.
I said an electric fire plug.
An electric fire plug.
Make his hair stand up and his ears and all that.
Okay, so there we are. I have a scoreless tie at the end of round one, but things will get better, friends, right after this message. You really are a different person since you've grown that beard. I mean, I've never seen such madness.
I'm going to grow hair on my legs. I'm really be funny.
Yeah. Okay, let's go to round two. Gail, A or B?
A again, please.
A again. Your little brother is going to really be sore at you, boy. Ralph said, I'll never fly on El Cheapo Airlines again. I knew we were in trouble when instead of the pilot's voice, I heard the voice of blank. Instead of the pilot's voice, I heard the voice of blank. Instead of the pilot's voice, I heard the voice of blank.
Knew we were in trouble, right?
Right, I knew we were in trouble. El Cheapo Airlines. All those are key elements.
Cheapo.
El Cheapo.
Oh, Bill, sweetheart, maybe you better shave off your beard.
I just recently flew on Air New England.
Oh, you did?
They have the best 1934 Fairchilds.
Yes, right.
I flew on that one.
Yes. Unfortunately, I rely on them in a great deal.
Oh, you poor treasure.
I don't know what this means either.
Ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. Ralph said, I'll never fly on El Cheapo Airlines again. I knew we were in trouble when instead of the pilot's voice, I heard the voice of...
Howard Cosell.
Now, may I inquire about that, please? I would like to know the logic of a psychologist's mind to come up with an answer like Howard Cosell in a situation like this. Please oblige me.
Well, he can't do anything right. I disagree.
Oh, all right. Okay. Now I understand it, and I agree. He can't. Okay, Don.
I don't think this is a match, but I'm not sure. I said the Lord.
DeLaude! Yes. Yes, I heard the voice of God, or DeLaude. What do you say?
Well, the reason she said Howard Cosell is why we all say it when we all go, what could the answer be? Oh, just say Howard Cosell, right?
Yes.
Now, unfortunately, I didn't. I said God.
The voice of God. All right.
I said the voice of doom.
The voice of doom. Voice of Doom and Voice of God, I think, would be the two good responses there. Although I'm amused by Howard Cosell.
Well.
Got it? There?
I wonder if you'll be amused by Cal Worthington.
Cal Worthington! I knew we were in trouble when instead of the pilot's voice, I heard the voice of Cal Worthington. Yes, I am amused by that. We are amused. Okay, what do you got there?
I pass.
You pass? No.
I have to say this one?
Yeah.
I'm sorry about this.
You changed
I said
your mind?
That. Yeah, we can't read this, fortunately, because I wrote a face. I said you heard of the guy, voice of the guy flushing the John in the toilet.
But, yeah. I heard the voice of
the guy flushing the John in the toilet. Yeah. That's how cheap that airplane was. That's I could hear the guy in the John.
I see. No soundproofing. Right. Okay. Ruffle up your eyebrows a little more there. Okay, Patty Deutsch.
Reprise of Doom.
Doom it is. Yeah, voice of Doom, voice of God, darn. Now, here, Jay, this is twice in a row that you've had a chance to win by just matching one star.
Okay.
What? No, you want to do this later, huh? Want to do this now or later? Do it now. All right, we'll put this back here and do a little business with America, and then we'll carry on. Jay, one shot is all you need here.
Okay.
Match one celebrity and win another game. That'll be your fourth win. Rodney Rich does everything formal. Even when he goes on a picnic, the ants need a blank to get in. Rodney Rich does everything formal. Even when he goes on a picnic, the ants need a blank. Right. Rodney Rich does everything formal. Even when he goes on a picnic. Blank. Ants need a blank to get in. Something like that.
Now, is our Helen still snowed in Massachusetts?
She's, the snow abated, but she got a bad cold.
Oh.
And she'll be back in a day or so.
Well, then I'll just go ahead and make the reservation then.
Yes, of course. I talked to her this morning, and she says, how's old Brett?
The nerve of
those seats. I said old. No. Okay, Chuck, here we go. Rodney Rich does everything formal. Even when he goes on a picnic, the ants need a blank to get in.
I'd say the ants need an invitation to get in.
An invitation. Well, that's kind of formal, I guess.
I think there are two excellent answers to this, and just to be different, I'd pick the right one.
Invitation wins again. Another rest again. Gardner, who a pleasure to meet you, Gail.
It was a pleasure being on the show with Bill. I've loved him for almost 6 years.
He is wonderful, isn't he?
Right,
yes.
Yeah.
We're going to send some gifts from Match Game 79 to Gail Gardner. Thank you. Ready? This is your fourth win. You now have $1,650. Let's see how you'll do this time.
Okay.
We polled the studio audience and said, please write down your best answer to this blank mud. Remember, 500 for the most popular, 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third. Whom do you call on?
I think we'll start with Bill.
Oh! Pull yourself together. It's only a game. It's nothing. It's not important.
I've never been picked on this show. You can't pick me. I've never been picked on this show.
Yes, you have. No, it's easy.
Okay, I'd say Mississippi Mud.
Mississippi Mud is good. You can beat your feet on the Mississippi Mud. Run out of town. Get it with party out of town. You. Okay, who else?
Brett.
What?
Brett.
Oh.
You know, Brett. You're the one.
That's my name.
Yeah, that's right.
What, Charles, is an old stick in the mud.
Stick in the mud.
We'll end up with Charles.
What Charles is. Why don't you tell him where you got that answer? Why don't you tell him you stole it from me? What Brett's property looks like in West Los Angeles, clear as mud.
Clear as mud. Clear as mud, stick in the mud. Mississippi mud are the three. Do you want one of those, or have you got one of your own?
No, I'm going to have to go with the response from the audience and go with Mississippi mud. Yeah.
Mississippi mud. You like that one best, do you, audience? All right, we'll find out who's up there, so where. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 number. Right off the bat, you get Mississippi mud. Well, that's curious. I thought it'd be up there a little bit higher. What's on to the next one? Clear as mud. Yep, there's Charles' answer. Now, what do you think is going to be on top? Roger Mudd. Roger Mudd. Now, wait a minute. He spells with two D's, but many times the audience, they don't pay any attention to the spelling here. He's a wonderful journalist on CBS. He really is. Let's see what we got up there. Stick in the mud. Okay, Brett had it. Now, you've got $100.
And I guess we don't have time to go for the 1,000 here, but okay. When we do get to it, you're going to have a chance to spin the wheel and see if you go for 1,000 or 2,000, but right now this. 16, 4, 3, 2, fine. Got 20 seconds here. 20 seconds. What do you want to do?
I thought we'd go up and dance.
All right. Come on. Hum something.
Hum something.
And Bill Tubman production. This program was edited for broadcast.